the most prestigious university in Taiwan.
那我也知道说，国立台湾大学是国内的，在台湾的这个最高学府。
And all the really smart nerds get to come here.
所以呢，可能就是所有最聪明的书呆子都在这边吧。So
what is today? What day is this? It's Monday. How about by Thursday? Can you get this done?
好，所以今天是礼拜一。那既然大家都这么聪明，是不是礼拜四就可以把成绩给交出来了呢？
I'm serious. Like I'll come back in a year and let me see what happens. Here's something you can do. Go to our site, biomimicry.net. Learn about biomimicry. I also really want you to go to asknature.org. It's a free website in which we're organizing biological strategies by design and engineering function.
所以我希望呢，如果一年后我再回来的话，我希望各位在这方面已经可以有一些成绩了。那最后呢，就是介绍我们的一些大家可以提供给大家使用的资源。首先可以到我们的网站是 biomimicry.net。然后另外呢，也请大家去我们一个免费的一个网站叫asnature.org。那这个 asnature.org 里头就有很多我们整理出来的大战界教给我们的一些解决问题的方法。
So you can type in things like, how does nature create color, and learn about structural color.
譬如说你到这个asknature.org之后，它的搜寻栏，你输入，到底这个颜色是怎么产生的，然后它跳出来的内容就会告诉你说，大自然界的颜色是怎么样透过结构的变化来产生的。
I also want you to really get involved in a design challenge. We have student design challenges. We're going to have, I think, 5 different kinds of challenges. And you get a team together of a biologist, an engineer, a designer, and a business student. And find a good problem. We have themes. And invent the future.
而且呢，也希望大家都能够参加我们所举办的所谓的学生的设计挑战赛。然后我们至少会有5个不同的主题吧。那这个参加的方式呢，是组成一个团队。这个团队当中有生物学家、有学工程的学商业的学设计的。然后我们会设定一些主题，那请你们提出自己的一些创新的设计。Here
are grand prize winners from the Water Challenge, 4 women engineers from Cairo, Egypt. Go.
然后呢，这个就是我们上次针对水资源所举办的设计挑战赛。那这个是首奖得主，他们是来自埃及开罗的4位学工程的女生。Or
take a class. We've got an online class about 3 hours. You could do an 8-month course. You can do a 2-year master's course in biomimicry, accredited through Arizona State University.
那我们有很多线上的课程。 有的是3个小时的，有的是8个月。除此之外呢，还有一个是2年的，有正式学位的，是亚利桑那州立大学所正式的一个正式的这个学位的课程，为期2年。As
you can see, we have way, way too much fun on our courses.
你看啊，每个人都笑得很开心，所以显然，上这样的课应该是很有趣的。Okay,
join Biomimicry Taiwan, which has been launched. Thanks to Agra Dragon, who brought me here. These are all our networks around the world. Talk to Julia. Could you stand up, Julia, please? Talk to Julia about getting involved in a network.
那我们现在请大家站起来，这位是Julia。那因为我们知道，在台湾，在这个新一峰的这个主导之下，现在会成立一个仿生科技产业发展协会。如果大家有兴趣的话，就麻烦跟 Julia 联络。
So do you think we can do this? Who thinks we can do this?
大家觉得我们可以做得到的，请举手好吗？
All right. Some people think that humans are just not up for the challenge. That there's something really wrong with us. And I don't believe that.
有些人会觉得说啊，对人来讲这根本是不可能的这个任务。可是呢，我不是这样的想法。
I went to Catholic school, kindergarten through 12, K through 12, and I learned a lot about guilt and how we have a black mark on our soul and.
因为这个Jenny她从小念的就是天主教学校，从幼稚园一直到高中毕业，所以她也知道说，哦，好像动不动就听到说人是有原罪的，所以呢，人就是活在这世界上，就是一定会有一种罪恶感。
I think that just gets us off the hook.
可是对Jenny来讲，这个反而是一种推脱之词。
Of course we can do this. We're a biological species on this planet.
因为呢，撇开这个宗教的观点不谈，我们毕竟还是这个地球上的一个生物的物种。那既然其他的物种办得到，人当然应该也办得到。
We're not aliens, we are nature.
我们绝对不是外星人，我们就是地球上面的一份子。
But here's how we're different. We're very young as a species. Homo sapiens sapiens is only 200,000 years old.And life started 3.8 billion years ago. We're 200,000 years old. That's all. We're tiny.
不过当然，人真的跟其他物种还是一些不一样的地方。因为我们说这个大自然已经有38亿年的历史，可是人这个物种出现到现在只不过20万年的时间。
We have a very big impact.
可是呢，我们却对这个大自然界带来了很大的影响。
But we can choose whether that impact will be beneficial or detrimental.
可是到底是好的影响还是坏的影响，我觉得是我们自己可以去掌握的。
Let's not call this the Industrial Revolution. Let's call it the Non-Industrial Evolution.
我想我们应该稍微要证明一下，我们想做的事情呢，其实不是工业革命。不是另外一次的工业革命，而是说怎么样去进行所谓的非工业革命。
So, this is from my part of the world, and I'll tell you a story. One time, I was back in the wilderness around the forests around my house, big wilderness, and I was skiing in the winter.On cross-country skis, long skinny skis.
跟大家讲一个故事。这个就是简妮她住的这个地方。那她住的这个房子的附近呢，就是有一大片的这个森林地。那有一年的冬天，她在军营行所谓的越野滑雪，那个雪橇是那种细细长长的那种。
And I realized that a wolf was in the area.Can you guess how I realized that?
可是他在滑雪的时候呢，他突然意识到说，哦，这附近有狼。大家知道他为什么会意识到说这附近有狼？大家猜得到吗？他是听到什么，看到什么
？Here's what happened. I was skiing along with my friend, and I saw there's a tree called a ponderosa pine tree, and we often go up to them and smell them.Because their bark in the sunlight smells like vanilla.
那时候简妮是跟她朋友一起在滑雪，然后呢，这时候会经过一些松树，叫做庞德罗莎松。那这个庞德罗莎松的这个树皮很有意思，如果有太阳光照射的时候，它就会产生像香草一样的味道。所以那时候呢，他们的滑雪滑到一半，他们看到这些松树，就特别去闻了一下。
So I skied.Over to this tree, and I left the trail, and I got completely tangled up in a lot of vegetation trying to get to this tree.
那时候呢，当然他们在滑雪的时候呢是有这个滑雪道的。可是如果要跑到松树那边去闻的话，他其实必须要离开滑雪道。可是呢，这个地面上有很多各种不同的这个植物，所以呢，往上爬要去到松树旁边，这个过程当中其实还蛮狼狈的。
So as I was smelling the tree, and I was caught on my skis, I had this sense that something was around me.
所以呢，那时候呢，他就是在松树那边闻这个树皮这个味道，然后反正他的这个雪橇上面已经缠了很多这个藤蔓类的这个东西。可是就在这时候，他发现哦，好像这附近有东西耶。
I heard this loud crashing through the woods.
因为他听到很大的一个声音，是有东西在走过这个树林。
And I turned around just in time to see a 1,200-pound moose.
结果、就是、
charging towards me.
就这时候呢，他转头一看，是一头大概有1,200磅这么重的大型的麋鹿吧，就正朝着简宁跑过来。
Only he wasn't looking at me. He was looking behind him at the wolf that was chasing him.
可是实际上呢，他并不是为了要攻击简宁，他其实自己也是在逃命，因为这头麋鹿一边在跑，一边还回头看。哦，原来后面有追兵，这个追兵就是一头狼。
And he didn't know that I was in front of him, about to be run over.
所以他根本就没有注意到说，哦，我就站在他前面。他如果继续再往前冲，可能就会撞到我了。
And trapped by my skis.
而且呢，那时候我比较糟的就是，是因为我雪橇缠了很多藤蔓类的植物，动也动不了。
So you know how when you're in a dream, and terrible things are happening, and you try to scream, and you just go.
就好像你做噩梦，明明很可怕，想要叫，可是就叫不出声音出来。
That's what I did. Instead of screaming at the moose, like, "Hey, I'm here," I went.
所以他明明想叫，要提醒这个大麋鹿不要再往前冲了，可是就是叫不出声音来。
To see me right before he was going to hit me, because he had a huge rack, but his ears, their ears pivot almost 360 degrees. And he heard me, and he swung his head over.
可是呢，就快撞上的时候呢，哎，他原本他是一边跑一边回头看，因为后面的追兵就是一头狼。可是就快撞上简宁的时候，哎，他把头转过来看到简宁了。为什么？因为虽然麋鹿的这个脚是很坚硬的，可他的耳朵是非常柔软的。他的耳朵呢，几乎是可以360度的旋转，所以他最后总算听到了简宁的声音。
And he jumped up like a huge shaggy basketball player.
这时候呢，这头麋鹿就突然纵身一跃，就好像这个篮球选手一样，跳得老高的。
And he disappeared into the woods.
然后呢，下一秒钟就不见了。
And I never saw the wolf. And I thought, where did he go? Because it was so dense. There were alders, there were shrubs, there was no path.
然后呢，而且呢，他这个麋鹿不见之后，他也没有看到后面那头那匹狼。然后杰尼就在想说，哎，到底跑到哪里去了？因为我刚才我们说过，那个地方其实有各种不同的这个植物，有这个灌木啦，然后有这种藤蔓啦，然后说根本就没有路走，那他们到底跑到哪里去
？And then I started to look very carefully, and I realized there was a wildlife trail. In the vegetation, there was a very clear trail.That he takes day after day after day after day.
然后呢，这时候简宁他仔细看了一下，其实哦，虽然说好像这个四周围满满的都是各种的这个植物，看不到有什么样的路，可其实你仔细看的话，其实它还是有一些是野生动物他们平常在走的路。
So I skied on that trail, and it took me right back to the trail very, very easily.
那也因为发现哦，原来他们有野生动物走的这一条小路，所以呢，他就顺着这条小路又回到了他的滑雪道，那就不像一开始的时候那么辛苦，要这样子连滚带爬的爬上来。
Just remember that other organisms have been on this planet for a very, very, very long time, and they know how to live here.We just have to ask them. We just have to quiet our cleverness and remember that they're trying to do the same thing we're trying to do, right? They're trying to live here and find great food and great places to live and care for their young and find an easy way through the woods.
所以呢, 我讲这个故事是要告诉大家，其实呢，有很多的物种。 它们生存在这个地球上的时间比我们长很多，所以呢，它们比我们更加清楚。我们有问题的话，应该多多的向它们请教吧。所以呢，不要老是自以为是，自以为很聪明。其实这些物种它们想做的事情跟我们是一样的，它们只是希望能够有一个好的生活，有足够的东西吃，有一个好的这个生活环境，能够来照顾它们的下一代。所以其实重点就是。
So I want you to go out and hang out with the cicadas.
所以呢，回到我们一开始介绍这个蝉，这附近就有很多的蝉，不要忘了，出去的时候就要跟这些老师打声招呼。
And I want you to remember that this planet is their home, but it's your home too.
然后除此之外呢，不要忘了我们所生活的这个地球。
既是他们的家，也是我们的家。Okay. All right, it's time to make our way home. Okay, thanks, guys.
所以现在最重要就是我们要找到自己的回家的路。谢谢。
Now the forum is open for only one question because of the time constraint that we are experiencing. But the organizing committee is happy to take all of your questions through our website at www.biomimicrytaiwan.org. So please raise your hand for a question. Well.
Thank you, Dr. Bayans. I learned a lot from this talk. I have one question. Despite the structure, life is always in a dynamic equilibrium.
Yeah.
So if human want to mimic the life, how the 3D printed product can renew itself?
Dynamic non-equilibrium.
Just like the algae, you have mentioned the silica layer in the cell wall of the diatom. Even this algae can renew its cell wall.
Yeah.
So if we want to mimic this kind of product, how can we make a product have its own life?
I think you just found your PhD thesis.
Yeah, maybe I can work on it.
I think you can. I think that you're absolutely right. One of life's principles is that life maintains itself through turnover. You know, it heals, right? There's the beginning. Type in self-healing materials on the web. You'll see that there's the beginning of this. But you're absolutely right. We want our materials to last for a long, long time sometimes. And so the best thing to do is to give them the ability to renew themselves somehow. That's your thesis. Excellent. Thanks.
So how do you think about the next big challenge about the 3D printed? Is that a renewability?
Is it what?
It's a renewability.
You know, you go to the 3D printing conferences now, and they don't even have a track about sustainability or green. It's scary. So yes, I think the next thing is to start to think this way, and this is kind of a time where we have to pull together, I think, and create consortiums, cooperative networks of people working on different parts of it, But we have to work on this one, I think, in a systems way, right? And so we have to organize ourselves to take different pieces of this. No one piece is more important than the other. It's almost like we need to, and we can't all work on, you know, all of them. So it's gonna really challenge us culturally, I think, to cooperate in our research and cooperate in our economic development. Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
所以我们知道大自然界，其实我们观察这些所有的生物体，它是属于一种动态平衡。那所以，如果是3D
打印出来的这产品，它怎么样能够有自我更新的这个功能呢？即便像是细藻这样的这个细胞壁，它也都可以有这种活化的功能。那Jenny的这个回答是说，基本上就可以当做一个博士论文，所以它等于是替自己找到了未来的一个研究的方向。
那而且也建议大家可以去我刚才介绍的这个网站，就是asnature.org， 你只要输入 self-healing material， 那里头呢就会有很多关于具有自我修复功能的这种材料的资讯。那另外一个问题是问到说，那 3D 的这个列印，下一个重大的突破技术会不会来自所谓的这种所谓自我更新的这个功能？那不过简令他刚才的回答是说。 反正有关 3D 列印这个主题，我们要研究的东西还非常的多，所以也不是任何人可以独立完成的。那现在可能一个比较严重的缺失是在于，现在在谈论 3D 技术的这种国际研讨会当中，并没有摆进太多有关所谓的绿色产业或是永续发展这样的概念。所以希望以后结合大家的力量，每个人呢挑选一个特定的主题，然后众志成城，也许就可以看到一些新的突破跟结果。
Let's thank Dr. Daniels with our warmest applause. Remember to forward your questions to the website and to create and have one in my biomimicry. And remember also, due on Thursday.
谢谢各位。